Now with us today to talk about the market and more is the head of sales at Regina Capital Development Corporation, Luis Limlingan. Hi, Luis. Good morning and thanks for being here with us.
Hi. Happy Monday. Maiki, thank you for having me.
Happy Monday indeed. The market's up. Do you think the market's going to be sustaining its momentum? September inflation came in, surprised to the upside at 1.9%, marking the first time in 4 years that inflation has fallen below 2%. Luis, do you think the market's going to be sustaining its momentum on account of this?
Perhaps I'm the wrong person to ask because I work right in the thick of things. And for me, it's always an opportunity to buy. So probably when I say it, there's going to be some bias to it. But we hope that it's going to continue. Of course, there are some events that might have some buying opportunities in the sense that probably some investors might keep to cash while waiting, which is the US CPI, which is going to be out, I think, on the 10th of October. Remember, we just released ours on Friday. Much better than expected. And I think that's what's already fueling this momentum early in the morning.
Mm-hmm. Talking about fueling this momentum, let's take a look at the central bank. How much room does this give them to cut interest rates, given that inflation is cooling? It has cooled even below 2% for September.
Well, I think, again, this gives central bank more room to maneuver tactically when they want to cut rates. Some say that they could cut rates 50 basis points. Others say maybe it's going to be staggered, 125 basis point cut next meeting and another before the year ends. But at least now there's a lot of, they can really figure out much more calmly how to, cut interest rates, given that inflation is already benign. Mm-hmm. The target or the acceptable range was 2-4%, and now they're at 1.9%. So this is well below what they expected. Very, very good reading, at least for September, and everyone hopes that it continues for the final quarter of 2024.
Mm-hmm. How much of a rate cut are you expecting from the Banco Central, Luis, at Regina Capital? How much are you guys expecting, given that inflation has cooled to 1.9% in September?
Well, we're not discounting the possibility that there could be another 50-point basis cut. But again, I think they have to consider that it's not a foregone conclusion that we've escaped in the problems of inflation, given that there is conflict happening inside the Middle East. They also want to watch what happens to a lot of the business activity. Will lending pick up? If it picks up, then I think there's no need to be that aggressive. Will inflation also suddenly spike? Because again, if the interest rates are suddenly very low, this might, good that it's going to stimulate activity, but maybe demand will be too much supply, might not be able to keep up. So I think they're also trying to be vigilant as well. Mm-hmm. And then let's not forget what's happening outside. Again, the U.S., how are they going to respond when they have their meeting and after the inflation report that comes out on the 10th? The jobs report was much better than everyone expected last week. So I hope, again, the positive data keeps on continuing.
Mm-hmm. Given this positive data, Luis, what are the projections of yours that you're going to be revising on account of the lower than expected September inflation figures?
We're hoping that the inflation remains benign, given that fuel prices, despite the conflict happening in the Middle East, hasn't really pushed up oil prices. I think they're saying that as far as we are concerned, being a net importer, I think because they were fearful that the economy of China was showing signs of weakness, is that again, this would also trickle down into commodity prices, and that's what we've seen with the price of oil. Mm-hmm. But again, we don't want it so weak because again, China is a huge trading partner to a lot of its neighbors, and again, it's really trying to find that balance now, that you don't want inflation or you don't want commodity prices too high, but at the same time, If it's too low, that's already sending a signal that the economy is weakening.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Balance is key. Three more months until the end of the year. We've got October, November, December. What is your full year outlook for inflation, GDP, and ultimately for the PSEi, Luis?
You know, we're still revisiting because, again, all the data that that came out in the last 2 months has been much better than expected. I think for GDP, we were above 6%, so we're maintaining that. I think there's a possibility that it can meet or beat that, given that the second quarter was 6.3%, so much better than everyone expected. Inflation, probably we're going to be looking at it, because at the beginning of the year or up to the first half, we were looking at around 3.5%. So probably the fourth quarter, if it's two or below, we're probably going to have to revise our estimate downward, which is good as well. In terms of the PSE, I think we're just going to give it one more month, because we want to see, again, one is how the Fed is going to respond and what's going to be their rhetoric moving forward. Second, of course, is the U.S. election. And the outcome of that will probably set the precedent as to how funds are going to be repositioning next year, as to which economies I think are going to be the main beneficiaries of whoever presidential candidate wins the election.
Okay, now, Luis, in light of the changes in the macroeconomic environment, cooling inflation, lower interest rates, and the lower reserve requirement ratio of banks, and plus telling investors to position ahead of the elections in the U.S., in the Philippines, there's a lot to take into consideration right now. What are you telling investors to do?
Well, again, we just say be vigilant on the dates, especially when it comes to anything related to inflation and employment in the U.S. Take notes again of the meetings. Not just that, but I think leading up to it, there are always speeches given by the Fed presidents, respectively. Even this week is going to be very heavy. So you have to read into the rhetoric and how that will send a signal to the market. We have to always take note that whatever you view, I think there's usually a consensus on the street as to how they see all leading economic indicators. It's whether it's the inflation, the interest rate, and so on. So how is this going to align with your projections as well? And that's how you're going to position in the next few weeks.
All right. Thank you for your time this morning, Luis Limlingan, the head of sales at Regina Capital Development Corporation.
Thank you very much, Mikey.